हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मोहित शर्मा एंड आई वेलकम टू यू माई चैनल इन्फॉर्मेटिक प्रैक्टिसेस एंड इन माई बूटस्ट्रैप प्लेलिस्ट एंड इन इट्स सेकेंड वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट बूटस्ट्रैप ग्रिड सिस्टम एंड हाउ वी कैन यूज अ बूटस्ट्रैप ऑफलाइन एंड ऑल्सो वी विल लर्न अबाउट अ कंटेनर फ्लूइड आईडी क्लास बेसिकली. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट वन सेकेंड from my previous video contents and that is in desktop and in which folder it is bootstrap folder. Yes, there we click, there you can see that it was I created in my previous video. Now in current video I'll explain you that how we can use a bootstrap offline. So in this video I'll use a CDN, basically a CDN. This is the CDN in which a contents are delivered now from through the Bootstrap website or from the network delivery system. But now we are not relying on this if the net is not there, even though we can access or we can create our website. So for this file I have downloaded from the Get Bootstrap site and now extract it. Extract, okay, next. There's the folder, and in that folder we are having CSS file folder and JS folder, and you can see that number of CSS files are there and we can use these files. Okay, and JS file also are also there. Now we'll use this one, so I'll make some changes or use the proper this name, rename this, copy the name. And now in a link tag rel, and this is the href tag, there I delete the current bootstrap, this folder, and this is the version. There I paste the bootstrap one. This is the name of the file, and inside this there we are having a CSS, and then bootstrap is there and the min file is there. Other items I'll delete from there. There is no need of using these things. Okay, we delete, useless for us. Now we also change this file, also till this JS folder. Okay, now bootstrap, and in this folder bootstrap /4.1.3/test, and we are having JS bootstrap. And we'll remove this contents. This is an attribute integrity. There is no need of this one right now. And one more cross origin. There is also need no need of this one. So this. So now, only by using this way we can use a Bootstrap framework offline. And basically, it is a front end framework. So now Control plus S we press, and we'll see changes are there. No changes are there. It means it's working properly and it is working offline. Okay, now I'll do one thing. I close this one, and there I once again click, and you can see this, that it's working properly even offline. So this is this one first point is clear. Okay, now the next topic is about a grid system. So what is a grid system? That in my previous video also I'll explain about that. This whole screen is divided into the 12 grids or span into the 12 blocks, we can call it 12 blocks basically. So grid system, basically we can call it 12 columns or 12 blocks, whatever. So it is divided into these 12 blocks. So see that this time I'm using SM4. I'll delete all this, for it is spanned to the 4 columns. But now you can see that in how many columns. Refresh it, and okay, no changes are there. Control plus S, already there. In Control S, okay, this is the problem. Okay, now call span towards this call only, calling 1, 2, 3, control S. There it is, not working. Once again, what's the problem? Let's see. Nothing is wrong there. It is there. Bootstrap is there also. Bootstrap this. Bootstrap min. Address is there. This is having a bootstrap min also. Control S. Once again, we'll start. Again, we are getting the output this way. What's the problem? Okay, problem is this, that I'll use only call there, call class is there, and when we are using only call class, so automatically it do one thing. Where is the file? There you see that it automatically adjusts the column's width. So but now we don't want this, we want to span it to the first column, span it to the second column, second grid, and this is for the third grid we want to occupy. So you can see that, okay, now it's working. So now I'll copy this. Now only the out of the 12, 3 grids are occupied by this div, and now I'll paste it 1, 2, 3 more times. So now let's see, it's over, full. So we can count it, that how many columns are there. We simply give them the number also. We change the number. There I'll give 4. There I'll give 5 to this one. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And this become 11, and this is become 12. Control S. Okay. You can see that how many columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 columns are there. If I'll make one more column there, so that column will transfer to the next line automatically, because there are only 12 columns. So this is this one, the 30th one, 13th one. So this is, so it means that how that the screen is divided into 12 columns, or 12 grid we can call it. So this is. And the last topic in this video is that we want to use a flu ID. So flu ID we use in a container tag, in a inside a container tag. So there, if we give flu ID, so what is the working of this one? It increases the width of, or it covers the full width of the screen automatically. So yes, covers the full width of the screen, and bootstrap is responsive, and responsiveness we can see from here. You can see that as I increase it, the columns are automatically adjusted, and now when it is small, columns are overlapping. So this is about one more thing I want to explain in this video, that there are 4-5 different classes which we can use. Likewise, in my previous video, I'll use the SM class, this one, and this one is the small class. This one provides the SM for small class, and we are having MD for medium devices, and LG, if in place of SM we use LG, then it is for large devices whose width is more than 900 pixels, or not less than that, around 900 pixels. And the one last is more, one more last is there, that is XL. So it is for super large, we can call it, and it is for the devices whose width is more than 1200 pixels. So we use SM here, SM, this for small devices, and we copy this. I'll make changes first to this. This, there I make changes, there, copy this, control V, control V, control V, control V, and again control V. Okay, this, So this is completely a responsiveness when we are using SM, or either we can use MD, XL or LG. Okay, so it looks nice and it is completely a responsive site when we are using this form. Okay, so hope you like my video. Thanks for watching my video, and tata, till then, bye. Okay.